In this video I will show you how to write a request for quote for production and tools. You can use it as a base for a basic production and tooling contract. For this project the supplier will be responsible for building the production molds and supply molded part. This is a 5-year long production project. The supplier will be 100% responsible for the tool maintenance for the life of the project. I will start with the introduction page. Date, November 30, 2019. Due date, January 15, 2020. Dear Madam, Dear Sir. Your company has been selected as a potential bidder for the subject manufacturing of the listed injection molded parts and production molds. The production process precision injection molding as defined in the included injection molding tolerance guide. You are expected to meet all the requirements of this RFQ. Be certain to read all documents carefully and send your response in electronic format to the Alimir Tooling Manager and Alimir Director of Sales. Tooling Manager, Amer Janina. Email, amer.janinah@alimir.com. Phone, 810-542-2779. Jay Haker, Director of Sales, North America. Email, jhaker@alimir.com. Alimir USA Incorporated, 4709 Macro Drive, 78218 San Antonio. This RFQ and attachments are not to be shared with other organizations, except as authorized in writing by the Alimir Tooling Manager. Failure to submit a quotation in a timely fashion, or failure to respond to this RFQ in a complete, comprehensive manner may result in your quotation not being considered. For those declining to quote, reply no quote. These tooling and manufacturing terms and conditions shall apply to all tooling and production purchase orders and shall be construed, to the extent possible. Tooling means any die, jig, machine, fixture, mold, pattern, template, samples, models, gauge, testing device, equipment, supplies, materials, or other item which is purchased by Alimir USA or specially constructed for project. The supplier may not fabricate or acquire tooling unless a tool and production order have been issued and authorized by Alimir USA. Supplier must provide acceptable samples meeting all the requirements and level 3 PPAP specifications. The part submission warrant, PSW, must be appropriately approved by the Alimir quality engineer and final approval from the OEM. Any additional costs associated with acquisition of the tooling or manufacturing are part of the supplier's overhead and therefore will not be charged to Alimir USA. The supplier is expected to invest in and own its facilities, machinery, and other capital equipment. The supplier is responsible for managing all aspects of tool development, tool cavitation, design, build, launch, and meeting quoted cycle time unless informed otherwise, in writing, by the Alimir R&D manager or buyer. These responsibilities include, but are not limited to the following. A. Conduct a formal product design review for feasibility concerns that affect the product, tooling, or manufacturing. Communicate and track product design recommendations to Alimir USA in writing, which may include resolution to product or tool feasibility issues, simplifications of tool function, improvements to the product dimensions, durability, a tool designs, and cost reductions. The supplier must obtain written approval from Alimir Business Unit for any unresolved product or tool feasibility items before initiating original tool build or subsequent engineering change. B. The supplier will be fully involved and bear responsibility to ensure the quality and manufacturing capability of the tooling for the entire life of the program, including the service period after production balance out. The supplier will notify Alimir in advance of implementing any engineering change if that change will impact the tool's ability to produce parts per the 3D CAD files. The supplier will also bear responsibility for resolving fit and function concerns and will involve tuning of the tooling. These tool modifications are not engineering changes but are considered part of the tool build process to comply with the molded part fit and function. The supplier is responsible for tuning any features as required to comply with these requirements at no cost to Alimir. The supplier must receive approval in writing if tuning deviates from the 3D part geometry. C. During the tool design reviews, the supplier will ensure the tool shop is designing the tool for the press selected for production and ensure the tool design and construction suits the industrial standards for conventional tooling, the OEM tooling standards, Alamer tooling standards and his own tooling standards. Know that the OEM tooling standards, Part 3D data, Part 2D dimensional drawings are master. Alamer tool engineer and the OEM product engineer must approve the tool design, the final mold flow report and the tool bill of material, which will include columns and rows for warranty start and end dates with a column for the warranty description and maintenance for each tool component and tool steel cavities and inserts. D. The supplier is responsible for the tooling preventative maintenance and spare parts, so to meet all Alamer USA and the OEM manufacturing, delivery, and quality requirements. Preventative maintenance plans must be documented and kept on file by the supplier. Alamer reserves the rights to review the supplier preventative maintenance and spare parts plans. If adequate record of a preventative maintenance cannot be documented, refurbishment costs to bring the function of the tool up to an acceptable level will be at the expense of the supplier. E. The supplier will ensure and protect tools against loss or damage. The supplier will be responsible for the cost of repairing or replacing Alamer USA property if it is stolen, damaged, or destroyed regardless of cause or fault. F. The supplier must retain tooling for a period of 3 years after end of production and thereafter to return, transfer tools to the Alamer USA at no cost to Alamer USA. The supplier must obtain written authorization from the Alamer USA prior to disposal or scrap any tools, plastic resin molded parts, and etc. Tooling packaging, materials and completed product shall at all times remain the property of Alamer USA. G. The supplier must manufacture and package the product strictly in accordance with the Alamer USA specifications, the purchase orders placed by Alamer USA and any other reasonable written instructions or amendments to the specifications issued by Alamer USA from time to time. All parts must be packaged in a manner which prevents damage to the part during shipping and handling. H. The supplier shall promptly report to Alamer USA any defect, breakdown, or other matter or event likely to interfere with any performance of its obligations listed in this document. I. The supplier must use all reasonable care and skill in manufacturing the product and must ensure that all products supplied to Alamer are of satisfactory quality, fit for its purpose and accords in all respects with the specifications. J. The supplier shall be liable to replace any defective product at its own expense as follows. Alamer shall have the right to reject all or any of the products which do not meet the specifications requirements, provided that such claim shall be submitted to the supplier with the supporting evidence. In case of such rejection, the supplier shall, at the Alamer's discretion, replace such products within 2 days from the Alamer's notice of rejection, or issue a credit note for the related invoice amount and any additional related accumulated costs, include but not limited to internal and external sorting cost. The Alamer and the supplier shall decide in joint consultation which corrections can be made by the company against the reimbursement by the contractor for expenses for labor and material incurred by the Alamer in correcting and repairing such defective products. During the manufacturing of the product by the supplier must, at the Alamer request, supply to Alamer samples of such batch and shall not permit the products represented by the defected sample or samples to be released for dispatch until Alamer has approved. The supplier shall, upon reasonable prior written notice, permit Alamer's representatives to enter its premises at all times during normal working hours and at other times by prior arrangement with the supplier for the purpose of inspecting the equipment, the product, the packaging materials and all aspects of the manufacturing of the product. The supplier must not contact the OEM or other related parties without the written authorization from Alamer USA. The supplier shall not be entitled to manufacture for use by himself or for third parties. The supplier must not make any modifications to the part data or mold data without a written authorization from Alamer USA agreed in writing. Alamer may cancel an order Notification of cancellation of an order shall be given in writing to the supplier, who shall stop work immediately in order to prevent further costs. All tool and manufacturing orders placed are subject to audit and recovery by Alimir USA. If an audit of tooling and/or manufacturing costs reveals that the supplier has overcharged, the supplier will repay the overcharge through direct payment to Alimir USA in dollars. Termination. Alimir may terminate the production contract at any time by giving written notice to the supplier. The supplier must follow the Alimir standards for tools transfer at minimum cost or can be at the supplier cost. If the supplier is at fault, the supplier will pay for all damages and all accumulated cost for not following the Alimir contract. See the included checklist for tooling handover requirements as the supplier must provide as follows. 1. Master samples, 5 pieces from each mold cavity. 2. Dedicated checking gauges and fixtures, with 3D and 2D drawings. 3. Tooling insert sets and components, with drawings and revisions. 4. Actual and released part 3D. 5. Released part 2D drawings. 5.1 product drawing. 5.2 detail drawing number 1. 5.3 detail drawing number 2. 6. Specifications from the drawings. 6.1 process parameters specification. 6.2 testing specification. 6.3 special characteristics specification. 6.4 cleanliness specification. 6.5 manufacturing date. 6.6 material identification, colorant, and the supplier's contact info. 6.7 assembly tools and pokayok. 6.8 bill of material, and the supplier's names for each component. 7. Last PPAP release. 8. Full dimensional report for parts produced before transfer. 9. Serial production dimensional report, from CP. 10. Deviation approvals. 11. Released, latest, tooling documentation, 3D and 2D drawings. 12. Part history engineering changes tuning and weld maps. 13. Tooling maintenance history and the tool problematic areas. 14. DFMEA or extracts from it. 15. PFMEA or extracts from it. 16. Control plan. 17. Work instructions. 18. Inspection instructions. 19. Instructions for actual rework, only for info, no rework possible. 20. Special characteristics list. 21. Packaging data sheet. 22. Defects Pareto chart as lessons learned transfer. 23. PPM per defect. 24. SPC results. 25. Actual process description, parameters with tolerances. 26. Bank build. 27. Spare parts and the tools bill of material include columns and rows for warranty start and end dates with a column for the warranty description. And maintenance for each tool component and tool steel cavities and inserts. 28. TBD. The Alimir team is expecting the supplier to meet all the requirements were detailed in the original RFQ and contract and expecting the supplier to satisfy all requirements. Be certain to read all documents carefully and if you have concerns or disagree with any of the information we have provided, please send your findings to the Alimir responsible engineer with PowerPoint illustrations and a convincing details for we can resolve the issue systematically without affecting the due date for production. This picture shows the project full assembly, you are manufacturing only the ones highlighted in green. The assembly name is H5 positive and negative busbar layout. Notes. 1. The 2D dimensional drawings are not available in this RFQ. 2. The supplier will provide proposed 2D drawings to Alimir and then the Alimir engineer will work with the OEM design engineer for the drawing approval. 3. Know that the production process for this project is precision injection molding as defined in the included injection molding tolerance guide. 4. Know that the yellow and the orange colors must be free of black specks, black streaks, degradation, contamination, and discoloration from a long barrel residence and high temperatures, see the master plaque. 5. The supplier will be responsible for ongoing tests, pull test, open and close test, insertion, extraction and retention test. 6 parts with living hinges must not break or be brittle, must be placed in a moisturized and sealed bag, use bulk pack if feasible. Know that all parts must be packaged in a manner which prevents damage, warpage, and deformation to parts during shipping and handling. 7 parts must be free of knit lines. These are the 3 DCAD files names we provided with this RFQ. On this page I am showing the platform summarized timeline. 1 First shipment for pre-production builds events. You can ship from the mold builder facility November 18, 2019 for prototype build events. For all other shipments you must receive deviation approval from the OEM design release engineer and his team, only if tools still at the mold builder facility and parts available for the build events are not manufactured at the assigned production facility tools, home line. 2 The due date for moving tools to the production facility home line is February 3, 2021. 3 PPAP non-saleable. March 30, 2021, parts must come from the production press home line. 4 PPAP saleable. November 4, 2021, parts must come from the production press home line. 5 Full PPAP. January 6, 2022, parts must come from the production press home line. 6 Start of regular production March 4, 2022, parts must come from the production press home line. 7 End of production June 15, 2026. 8 We will provide forecast for the ramp up when available. 9 We will provide request for quote and purchase orders for pre-production parts orders. 10 After February 3, 2021 all parts orders will be sent to the supplier through EDI and the supplier will use the production PO for the invoice. On this page I am showing the first molded part size and the geometric volume which will be used for calculating the part weight. Weight equals the geometric volume in cubic centimeter multiplied by the plastic resin density. On this page I am showing information for tooling and production. Tools required: 4 cavity mold fully automatic and 1 full attribute gauge. The estimated annual volume equals 50,000 parts. The maximum annual capacity equals 65,000 parts. This is 5 years long production platform. Start of production SOP March 4, 2022. Tool must fit in the angle 85 ton press and the selected production press with suitable barrel size. Tonnage: please approximate the required tonnage for this mold, and use mold flow for verification. Cycle time equals 2 or less than 30 seconds. Fill system equals 2 hot drops, YUDO, open gate to cold runner. Cavity and core inserts AISIP 20 high hard, 34 to 38 HRC, and 420 SS, 50 HRC, for the thin cavity blades for the Christmas tree inserts. Part 3 DCAD file name, 89869 file 126634_3530984_2-26-19stp_change.stp. Part 2D, not available. See the included injection molding tolerance guide for precision molding. Material from PP to PA 66 per GMW 16036 PPA 66 BLK. The approximated part weight equals 6.156 grams, the cold runner weight is not included. The approximated cold runner weight equals 3.5 grams, must add the cold runner weight to the part weight, add to each part from every cavity. The plastic resin density equals 1.14 for this GM specification material, GMW 16036 PPA 66 BLK. On this page I am showing the second molded part size and the geometric volume which will be used for calculating the part weight. Weight equals the geometric volume in cubic centimeter multiplied by the plastic resin density. On this page I am showing information for tooling and production for the second molded part. Tools required: 4 cavity mold fully automatic and 1 full attribute gauge. Tool must fit in the angle 110 ton press and the selected production press with suitable barrel size. Tonnage: please approximate the required tonnage for this mold, and use mold flow for verification. Cycle time equals less than 40 seconds. Estimated annual volume equals 50,000 parts. The maximum annual capacity equals 65,000 parts. This is 5 years long production platform. Start of production equals March 4, 2022. Fill system equals 2 hot drops Yudo open gate to cold runner. Cavity and core inserts AISIP20 high hard, 34 to 38 HRC. Operator must flex open and close parts 3 times when hot before placing it in the box. This need full-time operator. This part can't be bulk packed and must be placed in the box in a way that prevents warpage and damage to the molded parts. Part 3D CAD file name, 89871 file 12636_353098.44.stp. Part 2D, not available. See the included injection molding tolerance guide for precision molding. The approximated part weight equals 13.47 grams, the cold runner weight is not included. The approximated cold runner weight equals 4 grams. Must add the cold runner weight to the part weight, add to each part from every cavity. The plastic resin density equals 1.05 for this GM specification material, GMW16036PPA66BLK. Molded material, RTP199X orange, Pantone 151C, polypropylene. PP, available in the USA only. The highlighted are additional requirements for quality control. One color must match the required orange and must not have black specks or splay. 2 No Kent lines. 3 No warpage. 4 No flash. 5 Hinge line must not break. 6 Belt buckles must not break. 7 Clips must not break. On this page I am showing the third molded part size and the geometric volume which will be used for calculating the part weight. Weight equals the geometric volume in cubic centimeter multiplied by the plastic resin density. On this page I am showing information for tooling and production for the third molded part. Tools required, 4 cavity mold fully automatic and 1 full attribute gauge. Tool must fit in the angle 110 ton press and the selected production press with suitable barrel size. Tonnage, please approximate the required tonnage for this mold, and use mold flow for verification. Cycle time equals less than 40 seconds. Estimated annual volume equals 50,000 parts. The maximum annual capacity equals 65,000 parts. This is 5 years long production platform. Start of production SOP equals March 4, 2022. Fill system equals 2 hot drops Yudo open gate to cold runner. Cavity and core inserts AISIP20 high hard, 34 to 38 HRC. Operator must flex open and close parts 3 times when hot before placing it in the box. This needs full-time operator. This part can't be bulk packed and must be placed in the box in a way that prevents warpage and damage to the molded parts. Part 3D CAD file name, 89868 file 12636353_353098.46_2-26-19.stp. Part 2D, not available. See the included injection molding tolerance guide for precision molding. The approximated part weight equals 8.1 grams, the cold runner weight is not included. The approximated cold runner weight equals 4 grams, must add the cold runner weight to the part weight. Add to each part from every cavity. The plastic resin density equals 1.05 for this GM specification material, GMW16036PPA66BLK. Molded material, RTP199X orange, Pantone 151C, Polypro, PP, available in the USA only. On this page I am showing the fourth molded part size and the geometric volume which will be used for calculating the part weight. Weight equals the geometric volume in cubic centimeter multiplied by the plastic resin density. On this page I am showing information for tooling and production for the fourth molded part. Tools required, 4 cavity mold fully automatic and 1 full attribute gauge. Tool must fit in the angle 110 ton press and the selected production press with suitable barrel size. Tonnage, please approximate the required tonnage for this mold, and use mold flow for verification. Cycle time equals less than 30 seconds. Estimated annual volume equals 50,000 parts. The maximum annual capacity equals 65,000 parts. This is 5 years long production platform. Start of production SOP equals March 4, 2022. Fill system equals 2 hot drops Yudo open gate to cold runner. Cavity and core inserts AISIP20 high hard, 34-38 HRC. Operator must flex open and close parts 3 times when hot before placing it in the box. This need full-time operator. This part can't be bulk packed and must be placed in the box in a way that prevents warpage and damage to the molded parts. Part 3D CAD file name, 89870 file 12663-5-3309847-2-26-19-change.stp. Part 2D, not available. See the included injection molding tolerance guide for precision molding. The approximated part weight equals 19.96 grams, the cold runner weight is not included. The approximated cold runner weight equals 4 grams, must add the cold runner weight to the part weight, add to each part from every cavity. The plastic resin density equals 1.22. Molded material, material GM specification GMW16529PPCHT gray. On the following 4 pages I am showing the areas which will be designed for spare parts inserts. The supplier must also recommend areas in the mold must be designed for spare parts in the cavities and cores. The supplier must estimate the production life expectancy for each spare part and thin steel condition, also must recommend the maintenance requirement for the thin steel condition and the tool. The supplier must document the warranty description as required on the bill of material.
Un poquito más, ¿no?